And what are you doing up here? The strange bird said to Milo. Hiding from the screech owls, I suppose. Sorry, Milo said. Does this nest belong to you? I didn't know. Yes, and it's not just any nest, I'll have you know. I'm the night bird, and that is a dreaming nest. What do you mean? Milo asked. Well, dear cat, anyone sleeping there will have his sleep flooded with dreams, the bird said. But it's a safe place, safe from those screech owls. So settle down in the nest, dear cat, and be prepared for the dreams. They may be sad or frightening or beautiful, but sleeping in that nest, dreams will surely come. And Milo's dreams began almost the moment he was asleep. First, the sweet dream about being back on the farm and seeing old friends. And about the time his mother left him with a doting babysitter. And then came a dream that was very sad. A dream about Otis and how they used to play together when they were young. Oh, would it ever be like this again? Would he ever see Otis again? It seemed so real. Milo could almost hear Otis's voice. But it wasn't Otis's voice at all. It was a cry for help from down on the ground. Milo woke up, and forgetting all about the screech owls, he climbed down the tree towards the desperate cry. Milo hid as an owl swooped down and carried off a field mouse. And though he was a little scared, Milo still followed the cries for help. Cried, and that bird, he'll be back. Take it easy, said Milo, working quickly to free the pig's foot. You're fine, Milo said. Now, do you know a place where we'd be safe?
Well, back with my family, said the pig. Come with me, come on.
The pig's family squealed with joy when they saw him return. And over the noise, the pig yelled,
Here, Mum, here comes the cat! Here, the cat that saved me!